Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, as we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins.
Destroyed.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him and said to him, "Here is a true child of Israel. There is no duplicity in him." Nathanael said to him, "How do you know me?" Jesus answered and said to him, "Before Philip called you, I saw you under the fig tree." Nathanael answered him, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered and said to him, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than this." And he said to him, "Amen, amen, I say to you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending on the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I'm sure we're all familiar a little bit with what angels do, right? Their function, right? Coming from the term angelos, which means messenger, which typically denotes more of a function than what they are. And what they are is something that we can't necessarily completely grasp. We know that it's easy to say what they are, right? Because they're just angels, right? They deliver messages. That's their biggest function. That's what they do. What we hear, especially what we just heard, is that they have infinitely more important functions than just that, like ministering to God or singing his praises. But I think even more so, especially when it comes to us, what they do for us is infinitely more important than we could possibly imagine. Every single person on the planet is assigned a guardian angel. Every single person, living and dead, has a guardian angel. I think I might have said this last year, but I want to say it again, because your guardian angel has been waiting an eternity for you. He's been waiting for you to be born, to be conceived, to live, to exist. And their job is to look out for you, right? That's your guardian angel. Now today we celebrate, obviously, what we call Michaelmas, right? We celebrate St. Michael the Archangel, Raphael, or Raphael, depending on how you pronounce it, and Gabriel, which all denote their names, even denote their functions or what they do. But for us, I think when we look at those kinds of angels, we want to see something great. That's the reason why we look up to someone like St. Michael, because in our brains, he's a warrior. He's the one who threw Satan out of heaven and all his fallen angels. And St. Michael the Archangel, he's actually one of the lowest ranks of angels. So if you want to say angels, our guardian angels, are the lowest of the low ranks of angels, archangels are the second lowest, which is perfect because God always uses the weak and the stupid to shame the strong and the smart, seemingly, which is awesome because it overturns pride, and I think it makes us like a little happier. Like, we always root for the underdog. So anyway, back to what the angels can do for us, what their creation, their assigning to us, our guardian angels. They know us better than we know ourselves, in a sense. They don't know what's going to happen to us, but every angel that's assigned to us knows our weaknesses and they know our strengths. And so their strengths are supposed to help our weaknesses. That's the kind of cool part about it. Like, they know us, right? We're never alone. Like, a lot of times we think that we're sinning or we're doing something without anybody seeing, right? Well, unfortunately, our guardian angel has to watch. And I imagine it's like watching a horror movie, right? Like, oh God, here they go again. And I think, like, you know, if we can imagine that in our heads, that we're not alone when we're sinning or whatever, we might do it less. But anyway, if we call upon our guardian angels, we invoke them more and more in our day-to-day lives, right? The more help they are to us, the more they might help us out with things, the more involved we make them in our lives, the more involved they will become. That's the cool part about them. So it's not necessarily like you're alone when you're alone. You always have that companion at your side. And I think, God willing, we make it to heaven at the end of our lives, they're going to be one of the first ones to greet us. And we're going to greet them as if we would like a friend that we haven't seen in years. Like, oh, it's you. watched out for me. You're the one who's been at my side all the time. Like, any of you have dogs or cats? Like, folks, like the animals we have that kind of accompany us, right? I think they're, in a sense, that kind of, if we're going to look at a pet, what a pet is symbolically, because angels aren't pets. But the companionship that animals offer us is the same kind of companionship that angels offer us, that they're there by our side constantly. I'm not saying you should think of your guardian angel like a cat or a dog, but just that kind of, when you feel like your pet's nearby or with you, and you don't feel as alone as you might have before, right? That's the same kind of thing that the angels offer us. We look today, the reason why we celebrate today at all, obviously, is to draw our attention to Raphael, Michael, and Gabriel, that they're, I would say, contributions to history. And if you get a chance to read the Book of Tobit, where you get to watch Raphael take on Asmodeus, I think, is it Asmodeus? The demon, like they go head to head in that book. I mean, that's awesome. It's a little adventure story that is like something that I think we've been robbed of. Because instead of angels, I think there's an old TV priest, an old TV bishop by the name of Fulton Sheen. So before Father Mike Schmidt was, Fulton Sheen always was. So Father Mike Schmidt's always been doing, Fulton Sheen did it first. He tells us, about how we've been robbed of, the idea of angels and the idea of the supernatural in general. That instead of the supernatural, instead of angels, which actually exist, you're given something less. And I'm not saying that, you can like one or the other, you can like them both, but I'm thinking of like superhero movies and stuff like that. The heroes that we're given now, people that we see on TV, actors, characters, sports, whatever, in a sense, those are less than what we have at our disposal. The angels are so much more impressive, so much more interesting if we actually take the time to engage with them. And I'm not saying like in pop culture either, because every single instance of an angel in pop culture is wrong. But I'm saying like in real life, engaging with them in real life, asking them to help you in real life. And I'm not telling you to make a choice, but I am saying that there is more out there than just what you're being given in the world. There's more out there. I think the angels are in charge, like the higher levels of angels are in charge of physics, right? The reason why supermassive black holes and the galaxies spin the way they do is God put them in charge of making his science work. Angels of beauty and stuff like that are the reason why sunsets and sunrises have such an impact on folks. Those are like little glimpses of heaven, and we have the angels to thank for that. There's so much they have to offer us if we take them up on it. Just like God has so much to offer us when we take him up on things. So, let's ask the angels, our guardian angels, to be more involved in our lives day to day. When your feet hit the floor in the morning, guardian angel, guide me. When your feet walk out the door in the morning, guardian angel, lead me. When your feet hop off the ground into your bed at the end of the day, guardian angel, protect me in my sleep. Those are simple ways that we can do it. Ask them for the help, and they will. Let us stand now and present our petitions to the Heavenly Father.
They may make Christ's call to service and find purpose to fulfill their emptiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for all in the world who are hungry or facing food insecurity, that this season may be a time of refreshment, deliverance, and plenty. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for all victims of natural disasters, especially for the residents of Florida and all affected by Hurricane Ian, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the response of the souls of all from our community who have died in the last 2 weeks. Rosalia L. Gowper, Storm, class of 1945. James A. Sternan, class of 53. Wilbur J. Noll, class of 54. Gerald R. Brawl, class of 62. Leona M. Lebo, class of 63. Robert M. Thomasy, class of 66. Esther A. Clerk, former staff. May they enter the peace of unity with Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of the intentions entrusted to the prayer box at the back of Mary, Queen of Peace Chapel, and written on the prayer board in the Spiritual Life Center, and for the students, faculty, and staff members in most need of our prayers today, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we place these petitions at your feet, and through the intercession of every angel, we ask that you would hear and answer them through Christ our Lord. I now invite our extraordinary minister students to come forward for their blessing. Dear friends, our brothers and sisters, Joey and Kiefer, Gracie and Caleb, will be administering the Eucharist to you. In this ministry, extraordinary ministry students, you must be examples of Christian living and faith and conduct. You must strive to grow in holiness through the sacrament of unity and love. Remember that through, though many, we are one body because we share the one bread and one cup. As ministers of Holy Communion, be, therefore, especially observant of the Lord's command to love your neighbor. For when he gave his body as food to his disciples, he said to them, "This is my commandment, that you should love one another as I have loved you." The response to both of these questions will be, "I am." Are you resolved to undertake the office of giving the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ to your brothers and sisters, and so serve to build up the church?
I am.
Are you resolved to administer the Holy Eucharist with the utmost care and reverence?
I am.
Dear students of Delone, let us pray with confidence to the Father. Let us ask this to bestow his blessings on our brothers and sisters chosen to be ministers of the Eucharist. Merciful Father, creator and guide of your family, bless our brothers and sisters, Joey, Kiefer, Gracie, and Caleb. May they faithfully give the bread of life to your people. Strengthened by this sacrament, may they come at last to the banquet of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, our Lady of all the
Holy
Church.
We offer you a sacrifice of praise, O Lord, humbly entreating that as these gifts are borne by the ministry of angels into the presence of your majesty, so you may receive them favorably and make them profitable for our salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise you without end, in your archangels and angels, for the honor we pay the angelic creatures in whom you delight redounds to your own surpassing glory. And by their great dignity and splendor, you show how infinitely great you are, to be exalted above all things through Christ our Lord. Through him, the multitude of angels extols your majesty, and we are united with them in exultant adoration, as with one voice of praise we acclaim.
Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, for they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his Almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
This holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them, as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who do this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us, who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Let us pray. Having been nourished with heavenly bread, we beseech you humbly, O Lord, that drawing from it new strength, under the faithful protection of your angels, we may advance boldly along the way of salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael, the archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavens,